Greetings, brother. I understand Islam has told you that Muhammad is the Comforter, and this is a topic on which I have many, many videos. But you have asked a great question, brother, and I believe I can give you a complete answer. You asked, why did Jesus leave? Why did he say, I must go so I can send him? I am sure you have heard the Ahmed Didat teaching on this verse, so I will not replay a clip of him speaking. It is repeated hundreds of times in YouTube videos, and universally repeated by Muhammad's followers. But before dissecting the Islamic teaching, let's first look at the verse itself. John 16:7. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth, and it's Jesus speaking here. It is expedient for you, and he's talking to his disciples, it is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you, but if I depart, I will send him unto you. The first thing I want you to notice, brother, is the actual text. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. Expedient means practical, important, a means to an end, of some benefit or an advantage. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. Jesus just said there is some benefit or advantage for him to leave. And he adds the Comforter will not come if he, Jesus, does not leave. From this, it is reasonable to conclude, it is expedient for the disciples that the Comforter comes to them. I really want you to understand that, brother. Jesus is speaking to the disciples. Jesus says it is important and of benefit that Jesus leave the disciples. And this is absolutely critical, brother. Jesus implied having the Comforter come to the disciples was expedient, beneficial, critical. So critical that this is the reason Jesus must leave. Jesus must leave so that he may personally send the Comforter. Your question was, why did Jesus leave? Why did he say, I must go so I can send him? Jesus had to leave so that he could personally send the Comforter to the disciples. The disciples needed the Comforter so they would have the power of God to spread Christianity around the world. Luke 24:49. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. Jesus said, wait in Jerusalem until the Comforter has come. Look again at the promise Jesus made to the disciples. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. Please read that last part again, brother. But if I depart, I will send him unto you, meaning the disciples. In John 16:7, Jesus said, but if I depart, I will send him unto you. And in Luke 24:49, he says, and behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. These passages speak of Jesus sending the Comforter. Keep that in mind, brother. These verses are Jesus speaking to the disciples. It is good for the disciples if Jesus leave the disciples, so Jesus can send to the disciples the Comforter. This is confirmed in the Christian teaching from the Bible, brother. Luke 24:49, and behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you, but tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. And later, when the Comforter came, the disciples knew it was the Comforter. Acts 1:8. But you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. And you shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem, and in all Judea, and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. Brother, the Christian teaching is clear and complete on this topic. And it makes perfect sense when you examine it as a whole. It is the truth and the whole truth of the matter. But Satan does not want you to read the whole truth that Jesus taught, brother. If you are still not convinced, if you are still holding on to Islam's claim that Muhammad is the comforter, from here we can attempt to analyze both the claim of Christianity and of Islam. The claim of God's Word, the Bible, is that the Holy Spirit is the comforter. The claim of Christianity is that the Holy Spirit was promised to the disciples. The claim of Christianity is that the Holy Spirit would be sent to them soon. So soon that Jesus told the disciples to wait in Jerusalem. I really want you to think about that, brother. Allow that fact to actually enter your mind and affect your thinking. Jesus told his disciples to wait in Jerusalem. If you are serious about the truth, brother, that fact alone damns Islam's claim. All by itself. So the claim of Christianity is that the Holy Spirit is the Comforter. And the historical record confirms that the Holy Spirit came to the disciples. Now the claim of Islam is that Muhammad is the Comforter. Both cannot be right, brother. An honest person must examine Islam's story critically, because it is either true or it is false. Islam's tale cannot be both. Now recall exactly what Jesus said. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. Please notice, brother, Jesus does not say, the Comforter is not here. But if you listen to Mr. Didat, that is the very argument he tries to make. And the foundation of Islam's argument is that if Jesus is going to send him, he cannot already be here. Here is the oversimplified proof clearly stated for you to see. Jesus will send the Comforter. Therefore, the Comforter was not already there. Therefore, if the Holy Spirit was there, he cannot be the Comforter. And if you watch Didat giving this story, he provides two examples to prove the Holy Spirit is already here. The problem with that argument, brother, is that Jesus himself clearly stated that the Comforter was there with the disciples. John 14:17, even the Spirit of truth whom the world cannot receive because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him, but you know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. See how clearly Jesus has stated this, brother. But you know him, you know the Comforter. For he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. So what about you, brother? Do you care what Jesus said? You have said you think Jesus is a prophet. Since Jesus first identified the Comforter, I think we should respect how Jesus described the Comforter. Don't you, brother? And as I said early on in this video, I have many, many videos already addressing this topic. Please ask any additional questions under those videos after you have had a chance to watch them all the way through. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.